Hello, everybody. Hey, just got home from work today, and I've been having a little trouble with this Richie water trough. It's just not been sealing very good, so the trough overflows just a little tiny bit. I adjusted the valve or the float Saturday. Forgot to check it yesterday, so I come out and check it today, and it's still dripping a little bit. So the guy I bought the Richie water trough from says these little rubber stoppers need to be replaced once in a while. So I had him send me a package when I bought the trough. So I've never done one before, so I'll take you along and show you how it goes. Of course, I got a whole herd of cows down here waiting for a drink of water. That's how it goes, isn't it? I don't know if you guys use these Leatherman tools, but I'll tell you, I don't hardly leave the house without them. Pretty dang handy. You can see mine's getting pretty rough. Broken screwdriver tip. And I've sent some of these back to Leatherman, and they're real good about repairing them. So what I've done is this rubber hose connected to that. I just pulled it out of the way, pulled the float off. It just got a bolt and a wing nut right there. So I think I can just screw that float valve out of there. I'm not exactly sure how that goes. That was all assembled when I got it. So I guess I had to take this whole valve all the way out. There was just two bolts that go through here. I'll show you when I go back in. But I've never been into this. This thing come assembled. When I got it, I know that thing just, this red part unthreads out of this, but it's wanting to be a bugger. I'll see if I can go get over on the machine. So I got this thing loosened up. So this thing just threads away from this main valve body. Well, I'm not sure how it works. So you see down in that hole, there's a little rubber stopper. I'll have to figure out how that thing comes apart. So I was trying to make this thing a lot harder than it was. So this guy goes down into there. Here's a little rubber stopper. It goes down into there. This guy goes into there. Like that. And then this is almost just like a plastic pin. And it just goes in there and holds everything together. Really simple. This just pulled out. And there's the rubber stopper. And then this thing just pops out. You replace this little rubber gasket. Looks pretty simple. We'll see if it works. Well, it's a good thing I ordered an extra valve. I broke this little arm off. So that arm, when you're threading that on, has to be hanging straight down. And it got cocked up a little bit, and when I twisted it, it busted that arm off. Luckily, I ordered a new valve with the new set of stoppers. So this time I figured out, I took the arm off, threaded the valve body base into this holder, dropped this guy in there. That's where that rubber gasket is. That thing just sticks in there, and then there's this little plastic pin. You just shove that in there. Kind of snaps into place. And that's how the float works. When I get it in there, I think that next time this happens, I can just push that pin out and replace this valve stopper without monkeying around with all this. So I'll show you how that goes back in there. There's two screws right there that just hold this valve body onto the side of the trough. It's real simple. They're 2 5/16. I just use this quarter inch ratchet. It's kind of tight quarters in there, my big old monkey arms, to get in there, but it's not too bad of a deal, really. Here's all the cows waiting for a drink of water. The whole herd standing here waiting to go. So one thing I learned on this, I didn't realize before, if you can see where this valve arm is and the floats attached to it, I had it facing straight this way. Almost, you know, like at a straight angle this way. Well, that float hits the side of the trough. So it's got to be like at a, I don't know, like a 45 degree angle from the body of the trough. Yeah, I realized that when I got it all put together, so. So I turn the water back on. You can see the water coming in there. So we just got to give it a second to see if it's going to leak. I'd like it to shut off maybe about an inch or so higher than that, but you can see it's a couple inches from the top of the trough right there. We're just going to give it a second here and see where it shuts off. Looks like it's just about shut off. It's just dripping real slow now. Well, looks like it stopped leaking. So I think we fixed it. That's about the right water level. It's just an inch or so from the top of the trough. And I need to take a minute and level this trough a little better than it is. But I think it'll work right there. Looks like we got her stopped.
Well, I think we got her fixed for today. Just seems like even on a small outfit like this, there's always something to fix. It's what keeps us out of trouble, I guess, but cows are happy. They're all up here lining up, take a drink, so. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good night.